a year ago now, I had developed pneumonia, and thereafter I discovered that I had developed something else. It was C. difficile.
C. difficile is a bacterial infection that causes hospital-acquired diarrhea. They usually get it in the hospital and usually get it after they get antibiotics. So about 20% of people who have C. difficile have what's called a relapse. It comes back. And in those patients, they have recurrent diarrhea. It makes it hard for them to get out of the house, and they need to kind of always stay close to a toilet. It can have a huge impact on their satisfaction in life.
I felt so negatively and weak. This feeling of insecurity from extreme diarrhea, and in consequence, I had to be very careful about where I was going and how I was dressed and all the rest of it. And this lingered so long that it was rather disquieting, to put it in a very slight manner.
Unfortunately, recurrent C. difficile is a real challenge to treat with more antibiotics. The way it's most commonly treated is we give people more antibiotics, which in a way doesn't make sense because we're continuing to kill the good bacteria.
I went in no less than three times, and in the one instance, I felt truly as though I was so far gone that this might be the end, so to speak.
Fecal bacteria therapy is when we take a healthy person's stool and put it into somebody with recurrent C. difficile. It refills the colon with good, healthy bacteria, which help prevent the C. difficile from coming back.
And I didn't know for sure how it was going to work, but I had an enema. I had been told that it was a healthy donor, so I was enjoying peace of mind, and certainly it wasn't painful, and it was decidedly more economical than antibiotics, as you can imagine.
It's pretty remarkable. The treatment works 85% of the time, and their lives are changed when they have normal bowel movements. It's actually pretty incredible. Of all the things I do, this probably makes some of the biggest difference for the patients who are suffering from this. One of the biggest challenges for us is making sure we have appropriate pool of donors. It's very hard to find a donor that meets all of our criteria so we can use their stool safely. And we also have to maintain a fresh supply of stool. It expires after a period of time. Because we're one of the few centers in Ontario that does this, many patients have to fly or drive more than 5-6 hours to come see us. It's not a complicated procedure, and really more centers need to start doing FBT or fecal bacteria therapy. And as an expert in the area, we're more than happy to share our expertise and what we've learned over the years doing it.
They had sort of waved a magic wand over me, and I felt, gee, life is still here. I've been enjoying peace since